17 and a half pounds. I made them measure twice because I was like, he's 30. Like, there's no way.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. We're here for a joyful celebration. Just to, bring new life into the world, especially in this living age, is a blessing. And now then to immerse that life, join that life with Jesus Christ, is a greater blessing. It's an eternal blessing for you and for your family. And so as we gather, just a reminder that if you have brought your child to church this day, you're asking for something in particular. So the first question I would ask you is, what name have you given this child?
Russell Owen.
And what is it that you asked of God's church for Russell Owen?
To be baptized, sorry.
In asking for baptism, let me remind you that as you've chosen to cooperate with God, as only a married couple can do, bring new life into the world. So you're now saying that you want to join that life to the body of Christ. And so I ask both of you, are you prepared by your witness and example to raise Russell in the faith, to expose him to the faith, to help him be formed in the gospel of Jesus Christ, so that he may come to know the Lord Jesus? If you are, please respond, I am. And to you, Godmother, yes, I asked you the same question, but you've already answered it, so I won't ask it again. To all here, I ask you, are you prepared to support this family through your prayer and your witness and your deeds and your words to help Owen Russell, the Russell Owens, be formed in the faith? If you are, please respond, I am. And it is with great joy that I sign Russell Owen with the sign of the cross, sign of our faith. Claiming him for Christ and his church, I invite you, his parents, to do that. This is a reading from the Gospel of Mark. People were bringing children to Jesus that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked him. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, "Let the children come. Do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it." Then he embraced them and blessed them, placing his hands on them. The Gospel of the Lord.
And it helps if you hit the... Oh, it is on.
So just what does that mean? Well, there's a lot of things that get in the way. Life in general. There is the busyness of life, there is work, there is stress, there's family issues. I mean, I could go through and I could come up with a list of all the things that occupy our time, that occupy our energy, that occupy our efforts. But there's only one thing that matters. What are we doing to build a relationship? Because you see, when all this is done and said, when it's all over, if any of us believe that there are pearly gates, I don't know if there are pearly gates or not, I assure you that when we get there, St. Peter or whoever greets us isn't going to say, "You know, Mike, that was a great homily you did on Sunday, October 1st. Come on." He could care less. I can assure you that he's not going to say, "You know, that was a great touchdown that you helped with. Come on in. I'm not going to worry about that. I'm so happy that you got straight A's that one last quarter of your life. Come on in. Ain't going to happen." What is going to matter is how we have lived out our relationship with Jesus Christ amongst themselves and amongst others. And so when he says, don't prevent the children, don't stop them from coming to me, that also speaks very loudly to parents. Make sure you bring them to me. Because if you don't, then you're standing in the way. Whatever you may choose, whatever you may decide, whatever you believe, whatever you feel, but don't stop that. Don't stop that. And that's what we pray for us all. Don't stop there. And your mother, don't stop that. Don't stop the children. That's our obligation as adults, that we lead people to Christ and do everything in our power to make sure. Amen? My friends, let us invoke the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ for Russell Owen, about to receive the grace of baptism, for his parents and his doctor. Lord, give this child new birth and baptism. Through the radiant divine mystery of your death and resurrection, join him to your holy church, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Make him a faithful disciple and witness to your gospel through baptism and confirmation, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Lead him through the holiness of life to the joys of the heavenly kingdom, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Make his parents and his godparent a shining example of faith to this child, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Keep his family always in your love. Renew the grace of baptism in each of us, we pray.
Lord, hear.
And we join our prayer with the holy men and women who have gone before us in faith as we pray, Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us. St. John the Baptist, pray for us. St. Joseph, pray for us. St. Peter and St. Paul, pray for us. All holy men and women, saints of God, pray for us. Almighty and ever-living God, who sent your Son into the world to drive out from us the power of Satan and the spirit of evil, and bring the human race rescued from darkness into the marvelous kingdom of your light, we humbly beseech you to free this child from original sin, to make him the temple of your glory, and to grant your Holy Spirit may dwell in him through Christ our Lord. Amen. May you have the strength and the power in Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And now as his parents, and all of those gathered, I ask it's incumbent upon us to renounce sin and Satan and to renew our faith in Jesus Christ. And so to all of you, I ask, do you reject sin and all its evil effects? Do you accept God, Jesus Christ is his only Son and the Holy Spirit? Do you accept baptism as a gift of salvation? Let us ask God's blessing on this water. Lord our God, may the power of the Holy Spirit come down through your Son into the fullness of this font, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Mark and Julie, is it your desire that Russell Owen be baptized in the faith we profess with you?
Yes.
Then I invite you and the Godmother to please come up. everybody. Russell Owen, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. So we'll finish it off. All right, so you can stay up here. Jake. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed us from sin and given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and joined you to his holy people. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation, so that you may remain a member of Christ, priest, prophet, and king, unto eternal life. Russell Owen, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. See in this white garment the outward sign of his Christian dignity. With family and friends to help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven. Does it taste good? Receive the light of Christ to you, his parents, to the God. This light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. May he walk always as a child of the light. And, persevering in the faith, may he run to meet the Lord when he comes with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. My friends, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you the newest member of the body of Christ, Russell Owen. Friends, this child has been reborn through baptism and is now called a child of God. For so indeed we are. Confirmation, he will receive the fullness of the Holy Spirit. And approaching the altar of the Lord, he will share at the table of the sacraments, call upon God as Father in the midst of the church. Now in his name and in the spirit of adoption as a son, which we have all received, let us pray together as the Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down. Lord God Almighty, through your Son, born of the Virgin Mary, you bring joy to Christian mothers as the hope of eternal life that shines forth upon their children. May this child graciously be blessed. May the mother of this child be blessed as well, so that now, giving thanks to you for the gift of children, she may always remain united with them in thanksgiving. Through Christ our Lord. Lord our God, the giver of life, both in heaven and earth, bless the Father of this child, so that together with his mother, they may by word and example prove to be the first witness of the faith